Hi. My name is Orli, and I bet you can see there's a lot of musicians here with me, and I got to meet almost all of you upstairs. It's nice to see you again. I play this instrument over here, the big black one. Does anybody know what it's called?
Piano!
Piano, yeah. So I am Orli the pianist. Can you say, good morning, Orli the pianist? I love hearing that, thank you. So now you all know my name, right? And you're here, this is Orli Shaham's Bach yard, so you're in my Bach yard, but I don't know your names. So I'd like for you to tell me your names, and we're gonna do it on the count of three, and we're gonna do it what in music we call fortissimo, which means really, really loud. And the way we count three in music is a big triangle. So I'm gonna go one, two, three, and then I want you to shout your name as loudly as you can. Are you ready? One, two, three. That was a little too loud for me. You know what? I have an idea. I heard you speaking, but it was so loud, I didn't hear anybody's name. How about we try to do it pianissimo? Which in music means as softly as you can, whispered. I'll give you three and you can whisper your name. One, two, three. Well, I like that sound a lot. But it was still a little difficult for me to hear everybody's name. You know why? It's because when you talk, only one person can talk at a time. Otherwise, you can't hear. But in music, lots of people can play their instruments at the same time, and you can really hear that. Think about that as we meet the musicians today and we hear them play together. We're going to start off with some music right now. I'm going to play music by Bach for you. So if you could take out your listening ears, make sure they're on tight, and listen to Orli the pianist playing music by Bach. Thank you. You know what I especially loved about that? I especially loved how well you were really listening to all the things that my piano was trying to say. We have today members of the woodwind family. Show me with your hands if you've ever had a play date with another family, where a family comes over to visit you or you go to visit them. Yeah, well, I've got all my woodwind family friends are here today. And you've all had some experiences in our stations blowing air, right? And seeing how that wind that passes through our body can move things. Well, these instruments are mostly made of wood, and you blow air through them. That's why we call them woodwind instruments. And we're going to get two of them to come up to the center of the stage. Do you know what to do in a concert to get musicians to come onto the stage? You clap for them. You did a good job. You got two of them to come up. We've got Tamara, the oboist, over here. And we've got Yen Chen, our bassoonist, over there. And you can tell that Tamara's instrument, that oboe, it's not as big as the bassoon. So for those of you who were talking with me about your pieces and where your note is high and where the note is low, the smaller instrument has the higher voice, and the bigger instrument has the lower voice. It's just like in any family. In any family, even in your family, somebody's voice is lower than somebody else's. And usually that's the biggest person. They have the lowest voice. In this case, our bassoon has the lowest voice, and I kind of want to hear what it sounds like. So this is a low bassoon sound. That is pretty cool. I think I felt the whole room shake. Did you feel that? That's really great. And the way that she's making that sound, she's blowing air through her reed. She's going to show you what that reed is. The reed is just little pieces of wood that are vibrating together. And this is what it sounds like when she blows just into the reed. So that's really tiny and it's really high, right? And then she's going to put it into her bocal, which is going to make it a little bit longer. It's going to get a little bit lower, too. Still doesn't sound very much like her bassoon. Now she's going to put that into that entire big bassoon, and it's going to sound like this. That is one of the beautiful sounds that a bassoon can make. Thank you, Yen Chen. We also have here Tamara, the oboist. She also has a double reed, and her double reed sounds like this. Some pretty nice sounds. If the two of them communicate with those sounds, I'm not sure exactly what they're trying to say, but I like it. They can have a whole conversation. Now, when Tamara puts her double reed into her oboe, it sounds like this. That's beautiful, right? When we're going to do a little game with Tamara, the oboist. We're going to play some breathing game with her and see if we can use our breath the same way she does. Now, she's been practicing for a really, really long time to use her breath. So she might be a little better than us, but we're going to try anyway, okay? We're going to take a breath in, all of us together, and then we're going to let it out, and she's going to play a note. Just a normal breath. So while we're letting our breath out, exhaling, she's playing a note. Now, this is the game. You need to try to blow the air out slower. So let's all breathe in. Let's see how slow you can go out. That's good. That's about the longest I can hold my breath. But Tamara has a trick. She can breathe forever. She really can. We're all going to take a big breath in. Let's see how long she holds her note. You'll see you're going to run out of breath long before she does. So let's all inhale. And do you need air? I need air. She doesn't need any air. What is she doing? Do you need air? She's still blowing out the whole time. Can you believe that? She hasn't stopped. She's continuing. She could do this all day. That takes a lot of practice. She's not going to stop until we clap, I think. Let's do it. So Tamara the oboist and Yen Chen the bassoonist are going to play for you the same music that I just played on the piano, but it's going to have a very different color in the sound, what we call timbre, because it's on these instruments instead of on the piano. Let me give you an example of how they walk around in this piece. Sometimes Tamara's going to walk fast with her notes, and Yen Chen will walk slowly. And sometimes Yen Chen on the bassoon will walk fast, and Tamara will walk slowly. Sometimes they're both going to walk fast. So when you're listening to this piece of music, I want you to listen for who's walking fast and who's walking slow, and imagine what they're doing on this play date, just the two of them playing together. This is Tamara and Yenchen playing an invention by Bach. Thank you to Yenchen, the bassoonist, Tamara, the oboist, and to you, the audience, for being such good listeners for that. So sometimes when you have friends over, do you have only one friend over sometimes? Sometimes, do you have a group of friends who come over? So playing together in chamber music is like a big musical play date, and I want to invite some more friends over. Do you remember how we do that? We've brought Noemi, the clarinetist, is here. We're going to talk more to her in a little bit. And we've got Will, the French hornist, over here. And I don't know if you could see with Will's French horn, it doesn't really look like it's made of wood. And it's because of its history. It used to be made more of wood. And you use your breath for it, so we still consider it a woodwind. And he doesn't have a double reed like they had, but he has a mouthpiece that he's holding up. Can you see the mouthpiece that he's holding up over there? Maybe we can get you more in the center a little bit. Yeah. And that mouthpiece, first what he does is he takes his lips, this is the coolest thing ever, he's gonna buzz his lips. It sounds like this. So French horn players have to do that for their work. They have to make that sound. And when he buzzes his lips and puts it up to the mouthpiece, it sounds like this. That's really very impressive. And normally what he would do is he would take that mouthpiece and he would put it in his horn and he would make some sound out of that. And you could see with the horn, can you hold that up, that it's got all of this tubing that coils around and around and around and around and around and around. Remember we talked about the shorter instrument and the longer instrument? This one's actually the longest instrument, but you can't tell because it's wrapped around itself. If we were to unwrap it, it would be almost the length of this entire stage. And so it makes all sorts of deep and loud sounds. And he's got this bell at the end of it, which makes the sound louder so that it can come out to you and you can really hear it. Now, I wanted to show you what it would sound like if we could actually uncoil that. So here we are in the Bach yard, and there's something that you have in a yard that is perfect for demonstrating the French horn. It's my garden hose. So here's my garden hose. Here's my bell, or my funnel, for the end of it. This is what's going to make the sound loud for you. Now, he's got his mouthpiece. It's the very same mouthpiece he uses on the French horn. He's going to stick it inside the hose and check out what happens. It's coming out of here. And look, I can walk far away, and he can still play. Check that out. The sound is coming right through my hand. It's going right through this entire tube and coming out there. That is very cool. Thank you, Will.
Very cool, man.
Thank you. So now that we've got Will and his nifty French horn with us, we're going to play a piece for you. This is one of my favorite pieces of chamber music. It's really like a party for us to play together. It's by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. And since it's for five musicians, it's called a quintet, because quintet is how we say five in music. So please enjoy Mozart's quintet for piano and winds. Thank you so much. That was really fun. And it was a good dance. It's going to get us in the mood for our next music. But before we hear our next music, I want to really introduce the player who came on that we only said hello to, Noemi, our clarinetist. Now, Noemi, yeah. Noemi has a reed on her instrument. It's not like the reeds that the two of them had before. It's connected to the mouthpiece, and that's how it makes sound. This is what it sounds like when she plays just into the mouthpiece. I want to compare that for a second. That's a single reed, just one reed, compared with the double reed of the oboe, which sounds like this. I don't know. What animals do you think they sound like? Mice? Yeah, maybe mice. I don't know. Some squeaking. I don't know. Something very cute, whatever it is. I love it. But the clarinet has this kind of round sound, and when she puts the mouthpiece into her clarinet, she can go all the way from really low to really high, and it sounds like this. Yeah, beautiful. This next piece that we're going to play for you is definitely a dance. And when I listen to this piece, my body has to move, because with a dance, you kind of have to move. So here's what you can do. You can tap your toes, like I'm tapping my toes, while the dance is going on. This piece is about my hometown of Jerusalem. I was born in Jerusalem. And this composer named Avner Dorman, who I know, he's a friend of mine, wrote a piece about Jerusalem. Show me with your hands if you composed a piece today. A lot of you composed pieces, right? So Avner Dorman composed this piece, and it's a dance all about the feeling of Jerusalem. So for those of you who still have your listening ears, do you know where they went? And if anybody needs to go out or come back, you can always come back in, so don't feel compelled to stay. But if you've got those listening ears, get ready to dance with us a little bit in your seats. This is Jerusalem Mix by Avner Dorman. Thank you guys so much, and thanks for the great listening. We're coming up to my favorite part of every one of our Bach Yard shows, which is our story time. We've got a musician coming up here, and he's dressed a little funny. Does anybody have any idea what he might be? Maybe you'll have a better idea when he does this. Yeah, he's a bird. And he's got this instrument. What is this instrument called? It's a flute. And it's also not made of wood, but it used to be, so we're going to call it a woodwind anyway. He has a mouthpiece, but he doesn't have a reed, and he doesn't buzz his lips into it. He blows air across the top. It goes like this. And he can change it. That's a pretty cool party trick. Now, that's a very short piece, so the notes are quite high. When he puts it inside his flute, it gets longer, notes get lower, and he can play all this. His name is Leo the Flutist, by the way. Can we welcome Leo the Flutist? Now, he is going to be our bird, but our friend Will is very nice. He not only plays the French horn, he also doubles as a goat. Welcome, Will the Goat. Woo! And our story today is called Henry's Dance. Will is actually going to play Henry. Do you ever use costumes when your friends come over? Yeah, my kids do that all the time. So we've got costumes, we've got a goat, we've got a bird, we've got Henry's Dance, and we're going to listen to this story. You guys are great story listeners. Once upon a time, a goat in a petting zoo walked around his house looking for something to do. He looked here. He looked there. But Henry, the billy goat, couldn't find anyone to play with. Suddenly, he heard some music. The bird song, and Henry decided to dance to it. The song went around and around, so Henry went around and around, too. Tired of singing. He got slower and softer, but Henry came closer and asked if the bird could please sing again, since it was so nice to listen to. This made the bird so happy that he sang and sang and sang and even danced around with Henry. Getting so tired from all the fun they had that they slowed down their singing and their dancing. They both had many sweet dreams about new friends and dancing to music. To Leo the flutist, doubling as the bird, and to Will the French hornist as our goat. Fantastic job, guys. For our next piece, we have something really exciting. You all get to be part of this next one. Now, in order to get to perform in a concert hall like this, we have to practice first. So we're going to practice a little something together, okay? This piece is called The Curious Engine, and it's all about a really interesting train ride. And it was written especially for the Bach Yard. It was written for you, for each one of you. We're going to have to learn a couple of sounds and what you need to do. And the musicians are going to be like members of the audience. They're going to do the same thing that you're all doing. And I encourage people of all ages to be part of this. If you would like, there's some standing and there's some sitting that takes place in this piece as we go on our train ride. So first sound you all need to know is what it sounds like when you need to stand up. And it sounds like this. So when you hear that sound, can everybody in the audience stand up? That's the standing up sound. And when our cute little engine gets to all of the station stops, we're gonna stand up and do something at those stops. But at the end of each stop, before we have to get onto the train, we're going to hear a sound that tells us to sit back down on the train so we don't miss the train. It sounds like this. So when you hear this sound, you sit down. Oh, you guys are good at this. That's the standing and the sitting part. Not so hard, right? Can you handle some more information? Once you're seated on the train, this is what the train music sounds like. I want you to think about what you might be seeing out the window as the train goes. So That's what the train is going to sound like. And when we get to the stop, you'll hear the standing up music. And when you hear that, we stand up. And our first stop is going to be in a fiesta. So I want you to fiesta around your seat as best you can. Until you hear the sound of the train, you better get on the train before it takes off. And then we're going to ride around for a little while, and we're going to hear the cue to stand up again. So you're going to stand up one more time, and I'm going to let you stay standing this time. And we hit a carousel. And the music of the carousel and the horses are going to go up and down, and we can go up and down with your arms, too. We're going to do that. You guys are so good at it. I don't think we have to practice much more. In the piece, we'll then sit back down on the train. But let me show you what the last station stop is. The last station stop is a marching band. And our marching band begins pianissimo, very quietly. And it grows to a big fortissimo and then goes back down. This is what it sounds like. You can march in your place there. And then make really big moves. And get smaller. Until it's time to sit back down for the last train run. So that is all you need to know to be able to perform this piece. Do you feel ready? Yeah. Musicians, do you think they did a good rehearsal? Are they ready to play? Well, we have a really wonderful surprise for you. We have some of the Kaufman kids who are going to help us with the show. Please help me welcome on stage the Kaufman kids. Now, you know, all of you can be Kaufman kids at some time. Kaufman kids perform on this stage. They do all sorts of really cool things. And everybody who comes to shows here, takes classes here, can be part of Kaufman kids. So they're going to walk around when it's time for the train. But you can do all those other things with them. Are you ready to perform the Curious Engine and make your Merkin Hall debuts? It starts with a little introduction. So as you're listening for the introduction, don't move yet. And then we'll get on our train. Anybody who's not on the train yet had better get on, because it's about to go. Choo, choo! Choo, choo, choo! Remember what this means? Train's gonna get ready to go. Time to get off. And we've got our carousel ready to go. We better not miss our train. Last one, this is our marching band. I'm gonna start very quietly, pianissimo. Loud! Kaufman kids. Woo! Take a bow. And bravo to our audience. You guys were perfect. You got all your cues just right. And we've got one last piece to celebrate with you, one little bit of music that we like to use to end our programs. You know, in the time when Bach was alive, people wore these funny-looking wigs. So all the musicians and I are going to put on our funny-looking wigs. What do you think? It's a look, right? We're going to put on our Bach wigs and sound a little bit like Bach. And because this is our last piece, before we started, I just really want to say a few thank yous. First and foremost, thank you to the incredible musicians of Ensemble Connect for playing with me and for being game to do all sorts of silly things. Thank you so much to Merkin Hall and Kaufman Music Center for putting this all together and their staff. And thank you to all my Bach Yard staff and volunteers. You guys are amazing. We couldn't do any of this without all your work. Thank you. We're going to finish off with a little piece by Bach called the Brandenburg. We call it the Baby Got Berg. And after we play this piece, you will get a chance, if you'd like, to jam with us on stage. So while we're playing this piece, feel free to dance around with us. And then I'll tell you all about how you can come on stage afterwards when the concert's over. Thank you all for being such a wonderful audience. So our plan now, you can, if you're done and you want to go home, you can go home. If you want a little bit more, I'm going to play some marching music and jam on stage. If you come up the stairs on this side, they'll give you instruments. You can jam with us, walk your way across the stage, come back down on the other side, and meet your parents over there. Join us in April, everybody. Thank you. You guys can march across and jam with me. Thanks for coming.